guys, it's Eric. Today we are going to head to my buddy Abel's house. Let me see if you can see me here so I can get out of here. Yeah, you can see me. We're going to my buddy Angel's. I don't know why I said Angel's. Abel, his house. I don't know if you guys remember, but I actually did coilovers on his Mazda 3 a while back. We are headed to his house now, and we're gonna finish installing, I guess, his fronts on his car now, which is an FRS. It's pretty nice. And we will be doing my coilovers today as well, hopefully. That's the plan. And I'm sorry for the view right now, but this is what I can do for now until I get me a mount, unless I can put this float. Oh yeah, right there, a little farther down. So yeah, we are on our way to his house now, and I will let y'all know when we're there.
You can't see it.
My brother just boosted
the Infiniti, right?
What year is this? What year is this?
15.
15?
Alright guys, I had to head it back to the house real quick because I needed to get my jack. So, and we already did one side of Abel's front coilovers. He did his rears yesterday. So maybe by the time I get back, he'll have both of the fronts done and in. The only thing that was giving us some problem was a sway bar, like always. But I have my jack now, so we should be able to jack up both sides and drop the sway bar down.
In half a mile, turn left onto Babcock Road.
Drop it down so it gives us more leverage to break that little sway bar link off. But I got the bottom coils, the bottom keys off the rears from Jesse also right now, because he hadn't given me that. And he gave me these struts that came with these coilovers too, because I guess he had them still. But hopefully this goes smooth, but we'll see. Got all the coilovers on, camber has been adjusted. This guy wants to go crazy camber.
Last one.
Put the tire on and back it out, see how it sits. Then we'll do mine. Go. All the way. Snap. That looks good. That looks so good. Just wait till we pull it out. Look at that camber in the front. That's it right there. Rear's not that bad, but need to get rid of it.
All right, so I got one off. I was trying to find out how to do it, but I took the sway bar off on both sides, like we did on his car. It makes it a hell of a lot easier. Everybody says you have to take the tie rod off and the axle nut off to get the axle, which the axle does have to come off, but I don't have that 26 or 27 millimeter axle nut. So I did have the axle bolt socket, so I did that, took it off from there, and was just hammering it and it came out. So in case you guys need another way to do this, just try to take the axle off, undo the 16s on the bottom of the control arm, and it just pops out, and it should just come down with a little bit of persuasion on the back right there. But yeah, so one down and three more to go. All right, guys, so the fronts are both on. Now we're just gonna lower it and see what it looks like. Oh, man. Hey, that's good. Tires, isn't it?
Huh?
Sitting on the tires?
Mm-hmm. Nah. No, the other side is.
For real?
Probably.
Wow.
Ooh, boy. That looks good.
You can tell how it's all leaned up now. Time for the rears. The rear shouldn't take us any time at all, I don't think.
Probably an hour.
I would say.
Maybe, yeah. So the rears are on. Actually, I kept the OEM struts on there because the ones that I got, the nut was too small, so it didn't work out. And so I was just getting frustrated, so I put just the OEM one back on. And the springs, I wasn't able to put this on there either, the keys, because it didn't fit on the top or the bottom, but I think I'll be all right like that. It looks pretty even. So let's pull the car out in a minute and see how it sits. By the way, it's about to be 6:30.
Starting at 5:30 yesterday.
We're gonna have a sunrise pictures.
Oh, yeah. Wash my car real quick.
You're
still trying to watch
it. Yeah. It's really coming out already. Holy shit.
5:30 yesterday.
Look like shit.
I want to move it, but I don't want
to
go in my car.
I know. I haven't put an all-nighter like this in a long fucking time, dude. That looks really good. Wow. Like, if I look at it from the front. Huh? If I look at it from the front, it looks like really good. For some reason.
Oh shit.
I think the rear's lower right now because I have all the tools and shit in the back, but
the rear wheel does pretty high too.
Yeah.
Behind the fender.
We need to hurry up. That's rowdy. I'm pretty proud though. We did both these cars in the span of less than 12 hours, right?
I'd say probably about eight.
Eight?
And about 3 hours, 2 hours we didn't really do that.
Two coilover installs. Hell yeah. back home now, and this is gonna be it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I am all dirty, about to shower and go to sleep. It is 8:30 in the morning. I haven't slept, but I'm gonna shower, edit this video, post it, and go to sleep. If you guys liked it, if you guys are liking this content, you know, feel free to like, comment, share, subscribe. Y'all know the deal. But yeah, so I've been wanting to do this to the car for a couple weeks now. There's still some tweaks I need to figure out there. That's rubbing in the front. But other than that, the car looks great. But I hope you guys liked it. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video.